Hello everyone and welcome back to my channel. Chronic Clouds here again with episode 3 of our beginner series. Today we're going to be taking a look at the Imperial Japanese Navy Destroyer class and what makes it different than the other nations here in Legends. We will be giving an overview going from tier 2 through tier 7 and for the gunboat line tiers 4 through 7. The commander I'm using to base my stats off for the original line is Raizo Tanaka, level 16, Legendary 2, with Eric Bay and Reginald Triwit as inspirations. And for the gunboat line, I'll be using a level 9, Legendary 2, Takeo Kurita, with Reginald Triwit also as inspirations here. Now, let's get into this. The Japanese destroyers have some of the lowest health points of any other nation. They start off with around 7,380 health points at tier 2 to 11,970 health points at tier 7. As for the gunboat branch, you have a little bit better health points overall, really, as you start off with 9,810 health points at tier 4 to 15,900 health points at tier 7. Now for the guns are definitely the second option of armament, unless you're going up against opposing destroyers, which I recommend not trying to do. But in certain cases, they can handle their own as they're some of the biggest caliber DD guns. Starting off with 3 8-kilometer long guns with a 10-second reload, to 6 9-kilometer long guns with a 6.8-second reload. As for the gunboat line, they have a little bit quicker reloading guns, starting off with 4 9.6-kilometer long guns with a 9.4-second reload, to 8 11-kilometer long guns with a 2.7-second reload. Both have slower turret traverse, putting them somewhere in the middle of the pack. Now for the torpedoes. The main armament of any Japanese destroyer and the best of any nation in the entire game, so they're for their superior range and their devastating damage. The original Japanese DD line starts off with having 4,530mm torpedoes that travel 7.8 knots with 10,147 damage, 61 knot speed, and a 37.5 second reload. To 8 610mm torps that travel 11.2 kilometers with 17,966 damage, 66 knot speed, and a 99.8 second reload. And not to mention, at tier 7, you have the option to equip a torpedo reload booster. And as for the gunboat line, they start off having 6 533mm torpedoes that travel 7.8 knots with 10,147 damage, 61 knot speed, and a 37.5 second reload, to having 4 610mm torps that travel 10 kilometers, 62 knot speed, and a 101 second reload time. For the tiers 6 and 7, you have the options to add the torpedo reload booster as well. The Imperial Japanese Navy have good maneuverability, starting off with 36.6 knots top speed with a 2.7 second rudder shift, to 35 knot top speed with a 3.2 second rudder shift. With the tier 6 Akizuki, you have the highest top speed with 38 knots with a 2.6 second rudder shift. As for the gunboat branch of destroyers, starting off at tier 4, you sit at 39 knots with a 2.3 second rudder shift, to around 36 knots with a 3 second rudder shift. As for concealment, the normal tech tree IJN DD has the best concealment in the entire game at this given time. And for the gunboat branch, you sit around 5 kilometers as average concealment for the branch. Once again, you're a gunboat, and you're going to be shooting your main batteries, and in most cases, that's going to get you spotted unless you're in smoke or you're behind an island. So, the Japanese destroyers are the kings of concealment and torpedoes. They do well supporting teammates and caps, and they're the best ship to use at dispatching unwary battleships. And any good destroyer player can change the outcome of most of the matches you'll play. For the gunboat line, I wouldn't play them very, very much differently than the other line until you get to around tier 7, where your guns really do start to shine. So guys, that will do it for the Japanese destroyers. I hope this information was helpful, and if you enjoyed the video, please do subscribe. It means a lot. In the next video, we will go over the Royal Navy destroyers. And until then, guys, we will see y'all later. PlayStation.